Hi. Right, staying with acrylic. I'm painting on the other side of a piece of a watercolour that I did 2 or 3 years ago. I paint over them eventually. They're not that well, you know, they were good at the time. So bearing in mind the one I did the day before yesterday, the old oak and the path, I'm going to do something like it, just to make up a view and see how we go. But I'm going to do a lot of it in watercolour and see if we can just go in lightly with the sponge technique once we've got something going. So I'm going to do wetting, well, I'll show you my palette. It's the stay wet palette because things stay a bit moist on this. So we've got black, burnt sienna, ultramarine blue, cadmium red, alizarin crimson, yellow ochre, lemon yellow and viridian. I like viridian in the opaque media. That or sap green, whatever you take your fancy. I don't use greens in watercolour, I make them up out of the yellows and the blacks and reds and blues and the siennas. So just give that a bit of a wet, let that dry in a little bit. Using the hake, and we'll put a bit of a tint of ochre and a touch of red. I think that's just a bit of warm. You can see what happens, it bleeds nicely through the wet water. So that's a bit of alizarin in with this blue that I'm going to put in now. So a bit more blue in there, just a bit thin. Okay, well that's quite attractive. See what happens with acrylic on water, it's distinct from watercolour paper. I mean, the watercolour is that it bleeds out to a certain extent. I know it's not a good surface or a good angle to work on. But let's just flatten the paper a bit. It's not anchored, I haven't got a piece of, well I probably have. But it's £140 Bockingford, I think. So we'll just make do with that. So make sure that whatever you do, don't let the acrylic dry on your brushes, because you'll lose them. Right, now we'll put in a bit of yellow, a bit of ochre as a base for a bit of sienna in there as well. It's going to be very similar to the one I did the other day, because I'm familiar with it. It's uppermost in my hair, so let's have a bit of black and a bit of red in there. Take advantage of the wetness. We could go over with some nice greens, a bit of yellow. Just using the edge of the hake, and I'm getting all those nice sort of grassy looking things. Okay, and we'll have a path going through there, but now let's get a bit over the other side. I'm losing hairs off this hake, it's getting quite worn now. Now I'm going to keep the, I've got a bit thick there, but I want to just keep it nice and watery for the moment. No, that's not a lover of this Wilco yellow. I prefer the cadmium yellow, but I've got it, so I'm going to use it. It's difficult to do wet in wet in oil. Okay, let's put in some background now. Don't pull the hairs you hake, just squeeze them. Otherwise you'll lose your brush, the clumps will come out. So a bit of alizarin, a bit of blue, a bit of water. So we'll put in some leave some sparkle if you wish. Okay. So let's put in some nice green, so black and yellow. It's got a bit thick. Right, we'll put in some. We'll invent something to go along there. That's just a little bit even, too even, so we'll change the shape of that a little bit. So alizarin and blue. Okay. We're going to soon have to establish a light direction. And I'm favouring that way, so I'll put the tree there like I did the other day. I want to cover some of that, but the sky, you get some lovely effects. So that's not a particularly good example. Right, now I'm going to so let's have a bit of a cadmium red. See, that's not picking up the paint underneath. Once it's dry, it's waterproof. And we can add in some put some ruts or just marks. Right, and in a minute when we decide where the shadow is going to come from. I hope that this isn't going to look too much like. Like the one I did the other day. I'm not looking at it. I'm just ramping really, just making up as we go along. Okay, so let's get a blue and a red tree. So sort of a grey. The hake is a wonderful brush for this impressionist style, but you still have to use a rigger. Well, you don't have to, but But I'm going to cover a lot of this up with the sponge. Right, let's, so since this, the light's coming from the right, we'll darken up on one side of this. Sometimes you must gasp when I do things. Think, oh no, he's going to ruin it. Right, a little bit of green bush. Oh, that's far too dark. Okay, let's keep that nice and wet. I'm going to just put in some okay. All right, let's go sponging. I'm going to put in the, I'll just take my hake out. I assume it's all nice and clean. Right, nice and wet. That's that is still a little bit wet. So I'm just going to put the spring greens on. Put on the shadow side, we'll put some bluey greens in it, but I don't want to overdo this. I've just done one that was absolutely dead loss. I overdid it and it just looked terrible. So I'm thinking I'd better luck with this one, a bit of blue. quite a wet sponge. The blues and bluey colour hopefully will give an impression of shadowy colour. Oops. Right, now let's get some yellow in there. See how quickly you can do this. Right, let's get that blue back in there. Okay, so that's that. Now we've got to do the ivy. So ivy, so we have black, red. I'm sorry I can't show you the mixing, but I have to describe it because I just can't do the camera setup. Ivy in the UK will grow up anything that is static. Walls, trees, telegraph poles. Now we want some light, nice lights now. So I'm mixing a bit of ochre, a bit of white, and a bit of yellow, ochre and white, yeah. And the lemon yellow, of course. I'm not paying too much attention to colour realism. It's getting the tones, the lights against darks and that sort of stuff. So I'm just covering up the technique of the tree. So I'm losing it, and let me see what I want to do. Losing the shape, so green, dark green now, or darker green. No, I will show you the palette, but there it is, a wild mess. And I'm just sort of dabbing the sponge. The wetter the sponge, the lighter the touch, of course. Now let's just put a few little bits of oops. I sort of tried to get away from, let's pull that corner off. No, that's making wrong marks now. Okay, well, we can go over that in a minute. Right, might put a figure in this. Bit of detail in this. Bit of mud. Okay, right, now I'm just going to let it dry a bit, but I'll do a figure. and then we can tart the thing up if we need to. And then we've got a little rigger. There it is. So, what bits of red in this? Turner did this. Just adds something. Right, we'll do a red top because that all these greens. So doing. That's a bit. See if I can flatten that a bit. My figures are only sketchy, as you know. And then we'll put a shadow in. Just work it in slowly. Let's get his jeans further up my backside here. It's not very good at the moment. I'll just redefine that up there a little bit. That's a bit better. I'm sort of guessing this really, as you can see. Changing around this shape here. I think his body is a bit too long, isn't it? So I'll just get that blue up there a little bit. Show. Get his stick. Okay, now a bit of shadow. And I'll put a few more bits and pieces up there. But shadow, okay, hake. So a good shadow colour is always going to be blue and red. Right, but a bit more vigoury stuff. I say this every time, but you can spend a lifetime putting all these twigs in if you wish. But I'm doing a video and I don't think I'll be more. Okay, that'll do. I don't think my man is very, very good. He's probably too long. I tried to get him to scale with a tree. But, if I pop a bit of the alizarin on the back, because that'd be a shadow. And a bit under there. Now we have a nice, brilliant red. Well, that's not too bad. We've got a lighter blue on the front of his jeans, I think. Right, I think we could do with a few more bits of light in here, so a bit of lemon yellow and a bit of white. That's a bit of ochre. Right, I just want to just put some lights back in here. Right, I can't do much more to that. We'll put it in a mount and have a look at it. Bear with me, I can turn the page upside down. They always look better in the mouth. It sounds obvious, but they do. Okay. Right, let's put that. I think the best bit about it is the sky. Let's pull it up there. Okay. Bring out. Well, what do you reckon? That one there. That one on there. I'll put a signature on it. Now I'm learning to do these as well as you. I don't know if I can put some of this. Oh, that's reconfigured with 3 hours. Okay, well I don't reckon that looks too bad. Let's sorry about the error in the background. I might do another one later, I might not. I might have to do some gardening. Got to do some things, domestic. Right, let's come right into that. So there's my figure, I struggled with that figure. But he doesn't look too bad there. But the idea of putting a figure in, apart from an obvious bit of interest and a red against all the greens, it gives scale. You know how high a person is, and you know roughly how high a tree is in relation to him. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you soon. Bye bye.